Stop it, a whammy!
Today, these three players are after big bucks, but they'll have to avoid the whammy as they play the most exciting game of their lives. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now, here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter Tamarkin.
Rod, how are you today?
Super, Peter.
Super Rod. Okay, that's what we wanted to find out. We're all going to be super here today because we got super bucks. We got some whammies that aren't so super. Let's hope they don't come around. Let's meet the players looking for the super bucks, starting with our first player, Jen Meal. How are you, Jen?
I'm super.
You're super, too.
I'm super today.
You and Rod are both super. Now, that's an unusual name. Where'd you get the name? I mean, what's the derivation of
it? Well, it's from Virginia, but there's four other Virginias in my family, so that's the one I got stuck with.
Jin. You went with J-I-N. And you are from?
Cleveland Heights, Ohio.
Ah, from Cleveland. Great. Good to have you with us. And good luck.
Thank you.
All right. Our second player is our champ, Bill Dorfman, with $15,993. Trip to Africa for a safari. Not bad, huh, Bill?
That's great.
Now, what are you going to do with the bucks other than the safari trip?
Well, pay off a lot of school loans, Peter.
Student loans?
Oh, man. You can't believe.
I can believe it. Maybe you'll get some more today.
I'd love to.
All right. Good luck, Bill.
Thank you.
Our third player is Edith Corlett. How are you, Edith?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good. Edith, you are an attorney, I understand.
That is correct.
And you're currently going to school again.
I am.
In what capacity are
you? I'm in medical school now.
So you're an attorney you're trying to become a doctor.
Yes.
I think there are only about 100
There's
such
not
people.
Very many. I only know two, personally.
Yeah,
but
I know.
They're not very many at all.
Amazing.
Yes.
What are you going to do when you get out of medical school?
I'll do something in a medical legal, maybe malpractice.
Oh. You know, we're so lucky there's no malpractice against game show hosts because we're totally uninsurable. Well, good luck to Edith.
Thank you very much.
Both in school and here.
Are you ready
to play the game?
Ready.
All right, gang, a buzzing answer gets you three spins, multiple choice, one spin. Here's the first question. According to a University of Texas study, when it comes to childbearing, at what age should a man complete his family? Bill?
By 40.
Is the correct answer 40, 35, or 45? Jin?
35.
What do you think, Edith?
I'd say 40.
When it comes to fathering babies, the U of T says a man should wind up by the age of 40.
Yeah!
Bill gets three spins, and Edith a spin. Jin, give the guy another 5 years. I'm a break. Here we go. If you watch television, you know Morris is the most finicky feline. But what's his brand of cat food? Ah. The advertisers of Morris's cat food are now biting their hands. I'll give it to you multiple choice. If you're right, you get a spin. If you watch television, you know Morris is the most famous finicky feline. What's his brand of cat food? Is it Nine Lives, Friskies, or Meow Mix? Jin?
Nine Lives.
What do you think, Bill?
It's Nine Lives. Nine
Edith, yeah, they're saved. Morris picks up for Nine Lives. Jin one, Bill a four, and Edith the two. Third question. What man's yachting exploits and audacious business style have earned him the nickname Captain Outrageous? Oh, we'll do it again, multiple choice style. What man's yachting exploits and audacious business style have earned him the nickname Captain Outrageous? Is it Henry Kissinger, Ted Turner, or Frank Sinatra? Jin?
Ted Turner.
What do you think, Bill?
Ted Turner.
We almost went to work for him, but not going to happen. It's Ted Turner. Jin to two, Bill to five, Edith to three. Last question. Airlines, travel agents, hotels. According to Travel Holiday Magazine, about which do travelers complain the most? Bill?
Hotels.
Is it? Hotels, airlines, or travel agents? Jin?
Hotels.
What do you think, Edith?
Hotels.
Travelers complain most about the airlines, gang. Jin stays at two, Bill at five, and Edith at three. We're coming back with Big Bucks. Here we are. We'll be back. Don't go away. big bucks, players. All kinds of goodies up there, about $50,000 worth of prizes, and the prizes are some whammies. Stay away from the whammies. However, let's take a look at the big board and see one of the trips that makes up that $50,000. Are you ready? Are you ready for a trip to Waikiki?
Yes.
I'm ready, if you're not, a week in Waikiki and get lucky, and you could be right there on that famous beach in Hawaii. Not too shabby, gang. If you don't want it, I'll take it. And you know what happens? If you win this round, you'll play last in the final round. That's very important because it gives you an advantage. You know what happens when you get four whammies? You get really bummed, okay? Before we do that, we have added something to the board. We've added something called add a one for round one. Isn't that exciting? What it amounts to is if you hit add a one, you'll do just that. You will add a one. So in other words, if you had $1,000 and you hit add a one, you would then have $11,000. Not too bad, okay? With that in mind, you know about passing remaining spins. Least spins first, Gin 2, are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Here we go.
Oh, I want a trip. I want a trip. Go back. Come on. Let's have a trip. Let's have a trip. No whammies. Come on, honey. Now.
Stop at $200. All first right. Place. One spin, Gin. Spin Gin.
Okay, come on. This time we'll go for the trip. Come on. We want a real nice trip. We want to travel. Let's go. Stop.
Stop at $400. Right. $600. First place for now, Gin. Let's see what Edith can do with three spins.
Okay. Big money. Big money. Let's have only money. Only money. Stop.
Stop at Scottsdale,
okay,
Arizona.
Okay, I'll take that.
Edith, nice trip worth $526. Okay. Second place, two spins.
All right. All right. I'm still going for money or a nice trip. Money. Stop.
Stop. Whammy. How did he get a card is what I want to know.
No, well, I don't
left
know.
You with a spin, though, Edith.
Okay,
let's get some bucks
I can still do it. I can still do it. Money. Let's just have money. Stop.
Stop. No dollars, no spins left. Edith, we go to Bill with five spins.
All right.
Are you ready?
Here we go.
Champ's going for it.
Luck, luck, bring me bucks and stop.
Stop at Acapulco.
Yeah!
Bill, that trip's worth $1,488. You're in first place, four spins.
Go.
All right.
Go. Come on. Give me bucks. Big bucks now. Stop.
Stop. Remy.
That's okay.
I'm open. I'm open. Throw me the bomb. Throw me the... Oh, no.
Easy come, easy go. All right, you have three spins left, Bill. You
okay,
want to try
here
again?
We go. Come on. No whammies. This is for Grammy. Stop.
Stop at advance two spaces to $500.
$500, yeah.
Second place. Two spins, Bill.
We're going.
All right.
We're going. Come on. Give me big bucks and stop.
Stop at another whammy. Bill, you and Edith can commiserate. You both have two whammies, no dollars, but you have one spin. You want to take it or pass it?
We're gonna play.
Play on. Yeah. Bill looking for first place. Gin and Bill.
Come on, you little bugger. Stay out of here. Come on, big bucks now. Stop.
Stop. Another whammy. Edith $0. Bill $0. Gin with $600. You have first place in advantage. And we're coming right back after this for a whole new round. Don't go away. Willing and able to rock and roll all night because we're going to do it. I've got more questions. You're going to give me answers?
All right.
You think they'll match?
Yes.
Maybe.
Okay, it's a guarantee. Then you'll get spins. Here we go. Classical, jazz, or rock and roll? According to Japanese researchers, which type of music was more effective in soothing crying infants? Gin.
Classical.
Is it classical, jazz, or rock and roll,
classical.
Bill?
Classical.
What do you think, Edith?
It's classical.
Crying infants will be soothed by classical music. Gin to three. Bill a spin and Edith a spin. If you want to make your child cry, play rock and roll. Or make your parents cry, one or the other. Consumer Digest says this color house sells best because it suggests optimism, warmth, and sunshine. What color, Bill?
White.
Is it white, yellow, or green? Gin?
White.
What do you think, Edith?
Could I hear the question again, please?
Sure. Consumer Digest says this color house sells best because it suggests optimism, warmth, and sunshine. Is it white, yellow, or green?
I'd say yellow.
You'd be right, Edith. It is green is the happy house. Yellow is the happy house color. And Edith gets the spin and goes to two. Next question. What fraction of divorced women eventually remarry? Jen?
One half.
Is it one half, one quarter, or three quarters? Bill?
I'll say three quarters, Peter.
What are you going to say, Edith?
I'll say one half.
Eventually, three quarters of divorced women remarry. Bill goes to two. Last question. Not a lot of spins, but you could redeem yourselves. Here it is. What American general made his last stand at the Battle of the Little Bighorn? Jen?
Custer.
Is it Custer, U.S. Grant, or Stonewall Jackson, Bill?
Custer.
Edith?
It's Custer.
Oh, you bet. That little band at the Little Bighorn was General George Custer. Jen to six, Bill to three, Edith to three. And that's it. Big Bucks are next. Stay with us. We'll be back right after these words. $100,000 up there on that big board. Some prizes worth more than $5,000. You do not want the whammy, as you know. Let's take a look at the big board and see what one of those prizes is in that $100,000. Did you ever hear about three coins in the fountain? Well, when he was there, Rod Roddy threw in three coins and he took out six, the kind of guy he is. But you could be visiting this famous fountain. It's the Trevi Fountain. You could be visiting yourself during your six-night stay in the eternal city of Roma. Sounds good, huh? Sounds good to me. Most money, Jen, $600. That means you'll play last, and there's a tie between Bill and Edith with $0. Player to my left first, Bill, three spins, three whammies. One more whammy, you'll be out of the game, so let's avoid
no
the whammy.
No more whammies.
Let's get the bucks.
Here we go. No whammies. No whammies. I want Rome. Here we go. Stop.
Stop at $750. That beats the whammy. First place, Bill, two spins.
We're going. All
right.
Come on, Rome. No whammies. Stay away, you little guys. Come on. No whammies. Stop.
Stop it. Big bucks.
Bucks! Yes!
3,000 in a spin, yes! Bill. 3,750. Still have your two spins. What do you want to do?
Peter, I gotta go.
All
I
right. Go. Bill's going for it.
I gotta go. Come on, big bucks. Do it to me one more time. Come on, big bucks.
Stop!
Hasta luego! Arrivederci! Bon voyage! Goodbye!
Bill, you got Africa.
I know. These guys are only cute when you're at home watching them.
Different perspective you get when you're sitting on your that side, huh? You're not real pleased with them. I don't blame you,
no.
But you're going away with a lot of prizes. Stick with us. It's going to be a great game, I promise you. Because we're now going to go to Edith with three spins. And no dollars. Edith, let's see if we can do better than Bill did on this one.
All right, let's have big money. Big money, nothing but money. Stop.
Stop at 3,000 a spin. That's where Bill was.
Okay.
First place, three spins, Edith.
Okay, all right. I'm going to go. Come on, let's do that again. Let's have big bucks. Big bucks. Stop.
Stop. See, what happens, Edith, if you get another whammy, you'll be out of the game, and then I have to do a soliloquy from Hamlet. And that usually doesn't help the show a lot when I do that.
Know.
So we don't want you to whammy out. You have two spins left. What do you want to do?
Well, I'm going to go. You're
going to go for it. All right, Edith, looking for some bucks, no whammies.
Okay, come on. Come on board. No whammies. Money, big bucks. Stop.
Stop.
You're out!
Edith.
I know.
I'm sorry.
I know. No sorrier than I.
terrible. Eight whammies between Bill and Edith. We go to Jen with $600, six spins. Now, Jen, here's the way it works. You're playing in a, theoretically against the house, which means you can stop anytime you want. You can get a whammy and keep going. Obviously, if you work yourself up and get four whammies, then you'll all be gone. You'll join Bill and Edith in whammy heaven. So knock yourself out, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Have a great time. Are you ready?
Travel, please. Quick, quick.
Stop! Stop at 700 a spin. $1,300, still six spins. Jen?
Oh, I can go. I'm gone. Yes, yes. Oh, come on, Rome. I want to travel. I want to see Italian men. Stop!
Stop at a tent trailer. Jen, that tent trailer is $5,384. That brings your total up to $6,684, five spins.
I got to go.
Go again, okay?
Come on, honey, let's go. Stop!
Stop!
One of my jets, two of my gas. The whammies are coming to steal your stash.
To be or not to be? That's the question. No, four spins, Jen. You're not going to let one whammy scare you off?
No!
Let's go for
it. I'm going.
Big bucks.
We're going to get big bucks. Okay, we're going to go for big bucks. We're going to get some money. We're going to stop this thing. We're going to stop it. Stop!
Stop at a $1,500 on a spin. Still have your four spins, $1,500, Jen. Press or pass?
I'm gonna go.
You gonna go again?
I'm gonna go.
All right, let's get some bucks.
I'm greedy, and I wanna travel, please. Let's go. Come on, honey. Stop!
Stop at $3,000 on a spin. $4,500, Jen. Four spins.
Stop!
That's it. You wanna play anymore?
No.
That's it. $4,500. You're the champ for the first win. We'll come back and find out what happened after the deep work. Jen with $4,500. And Jen, it's been a wild and woolly game, and you don't get to hear the illustrious one, Rod Roddy, tell you about what you've won because it's all cash.
Yes.
$4,500. Well done. You come back and do it again. And Bill, you are leaving us with $15,993.
Thank you.
Send us a card from Africa. Good luck to you. Edith, thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Got some
very
nice
much.
Prizes for you.
Thank you.
And I have a couple of poems. Here's one from Cindy Moore of Fayette, Alabama. She writes in, "There's a whammy that dances like Michael Jackson. He thinks he'll get a lot of the action. There's one that rides on a shark-like jaws, and he can't wait to get your money in his paws. There's one that rolls around on skates. If you get him, it's your money he takes. It doesn't matter about whammy number four, because if you get him, you're out the door." One more from Larry Kaufner of Albuquerque, New Mexico. "Good old Peter, what's his name, hosts the country's favorite game. You whammy out or win a buck, depending on how you press your luck. Now, no one likes that little red guy. When he appears, you want to cry. So since the whammy's such a pest and good old Peter is the best, I think we ought to take his face and use it in the whammy's place. I say, let's have a whammy ban, and in its place, let's use Peter's pan." Clever, Larry. Until next time, this is Peter and Martin saying thanks for blessing your luck. Bye-bye.
BSN, the network for games.
We're just pit bulls, that's what we are.
Celebrity Blackjack premieres Tuesday night at 10, only on GSN, the network for games.
What happens when a man of letters joins forces with a man of many beers?
Hallelujah. It's raining men.
It's Win Ben Stein's Money. Ben and Jimmy are raising the roof at GSN.
Did you want to say something else?
Catch Ben Stein, the Emmy-winning Renaissance man of the new millennium.
That is sadly and tragically right, and it's also factual.
And Jimmy Kimmel, a ladies' man from the old school.
Only if you give me a little tongue, baby.
It's Win Ben Stein's Money, premiering Monday, October 11th at 6 on GSN, the network for games.